In this video, we're going to discuss how to graph the function y equals x plus 3 quantity squared minus 5. So the first thing to recognize here is that there's graph transformations involved with this thing, but we have to first identify what is the basic graph in play here. What is the basic graph? If we ignore all of the transformations, what's left? Like if we ignore this minus 5, if we ignore this plus 3, our function looks just like y equals x squared. And so that's the basic graph here, y equals x squared. And so in order to start graphing this formula, this function here, we would start off with this basic function y equals x squared. If you don't know what that graph looks like, that's okay. Many of you might have seen this before, but it's not a big deal. Y equals x squared is just our standard parabola, which looks something like the following. We might talk more about how to graph these basic functions very later on in this series here. But y equals x squared is just a standard parabola. It goes through 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 4, 3, 9, 4, 16, etc. here. And so on the screen, it's illustrated. It's this dashed curve in white. Okay? And so then once you've identified the basic function, then you want to start looking for transformations that are applied to it. So for example, notice that I replaced the x with an x plus 3. What does that do to the graph, x plus 3? That x plus 3 causes the graph to be shifted. We shift it to the left. We might have to reference the table we had from the previous video. We want to shift left by a factor of 3. And so you see that's what's happened here as we go from the white graph, the basic one, to the green graph, which is also a dashed curve right here. This function, y equals x plus 3 squared, is a shift of the graph left by 3 units. And I mean, this is exactly 3 units right here. Like this, the point 0, 0 moves over to negative 1, 0, to negative 2, 0, to negative 3, 0. Right, this point got shifted over by 3 units. And this happens for all of the points on the graph. Like if we take the point 1, 1, it's going to move over 1, 2, and then 3. We get this point right here, which is going to be negative 2, 1. This came from 1, 1. What did we do here? We just take the x-coordinate 1, and we subtract from it 3, which is a shift to the left, and then we get negative 2. So each of these points, we do this for each point on the graph, right? The graph itself is just a collection of all the points. We shift each graph to the left by 3. We just subtract 3 from its x-coordinate. That's where this green graph comes from right here. And if we want a formula for it, it'll just be y equals x plus 3 squared, like so. But then what else is happening here? This is negative 5. What does the negative 5 do? Notice that the x plus 3 is inside of the function. A good indicator of this is the parentheses, right? Our function is x squared. And so everything inside of the square is part of the horizontal zone. And so that's why the x plus 3 causes the graph to move to the left. On the other hand, the negative 5 is outside of the horizontal zone. The parentheses usually give you a good indicator of that horizontal zone. That negative 5 is outside of the horizontal zone, and this will thus affect the graph as a shift. This is going to be a vertical shift, so it's going to be a shift down by a factor of 5. And so taking this point we had before, negative 3, 0, we're going to shift it down by 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm just kind of counting the marks here on the y-axis. We shift everything down by 5. Oops, put that point back there. And so now we get this new point, negative 3, negative 5. It went down. And we did that for this point that started at the origin. If you take this point, that was at 1, 1, right? That was this point, right? It moves to here, negative 2, 1. We'll move that down, right? You're going to get this point, negative 2, negative 4. Where did negative 4 come from? It's just 1 minus 5. So to move things to the left, you should subtract 3 from the x-coordinate. A shift to the right would just be adding 3 to the x-coordinate. A shift down just means you're going to take the y-coordinate and subtract 5 from it. A shift up, you would add to the y-coordinate. What I want to do is switch over to the graph of this function. So this is the little Desmos page I created for this lecture. You can find the link to this in the video description here. I'm going to switch our function. We're going to switch it to x squared. This is now this is going to be the graph you see right here. And so now let's change things, right? We didn't do any vertical or horizontal stretching or compressing. So I'm going to leave the number A and B at 1. But the h value, if we have x plus 3, that means you're taking x minus negative 3. So switch h to be negative 3. You see the graph is then moving to the left by 3 units, just like we predicted there. And then for k is going to control the move up and down. So we had a negative 5 right there, so we're going to move this thing down by 5. Oh, that's moving it up, moving it down by 5. So we should have a negative 5 right there. Went off the screen a little bit, and I'll zoom out. And so you can see then, how did this graph change? The point that was at the origin moves. So the point that was at the origin moves down to be negative 3, negative 5. And the point at 1, 1 moved down to negative 2, negative 4, just like we saw here. And so the graph that we produced is identical to the one that the calculator produces. And so you see that here on the screen. And so that's what we're trying to be able to do in this section. How do we produce the same graph that the graph calculator produced without the need of a calculator? We want to understand the connection between the algebraic formula of the function with its graph that we see here on the screen. And we saw on this one that we just had a vertical and horizontal shift.